Hello everyone. In today's video, we are going to discuss about a string matching algorithm by name Horsepool. The objective, as in case of any string matching algorithm, the objective of the Horsepool string matching algorithm is also to find the occurrence of the pattern in a given text. Hence, I have written the goal is to find pattern which is denoted with capital P in the text. Now let's assume that the size of text be n characters. In the sense, I can denote my text D with an array of characters from 0 to n minus 1. And let's denote the pattern. We'll assume that the size of the pattern is m character, and the pattern P, that is capital P, can be denoted with an array P indexed from 0 to m minus 1. Now we know that one of the major problems with respect to the naive string matching algorithm, rather than calling it as naive string matching algorithm, let me call it as brute force string matching algorithm. One of the limitation of a brute force string matching algorithm was the shift size was limited to 1. In brute force, or it is also called as naive, in brute force string matching, limitation is if that the shift size is limited to 1. That means generally what we do in case of the brute force string matching algorithm, first we align the m characters of the pattern with the first m characters of the text. And we start comparing the first character. If first character matches, we go for the second character. Even if second character matches, we go for the third character. If third character does not match, then we might have noted that the shift size was just only 1. So in every iteration, the brute force string matching algorithm problem was the shift size was just limited to 1. So what we do in case of Horsepool string matching algorithm is we do some enhancement to the pattern. That means what I can say, we do some pre-processing for the pattern, and with the help of those pre-processed information, we check whether the pattern is there in the given text or not. That is, I can say in Horsepool algorithm, we do some sort of pre-processing to the pattern before searching it in the text. Let's see later what sort of pre-processing is done here for the pattern. So this Horsepool string matching, as we do some sort of pre-processing to the input that is the pattern, it comes under input enhancement. And one more difference when compared with the naive string matching algorithm is, I can say in naive string matching algorithm, that is naive or brute force, string matching, what we do is assume that this is my text and this is my pattern. First, we align the pattern with the text. Now, comparison of the character is always done from the left side. I compare the first character. If it matches, I go for the second character. If second character matches, I go for third character. Then I go for the fourth character. If this does not match, then I shift the size by 1. Now, I compare the first character of the pattern with the second character of the text. Second character of the pattern with the third character of the text. Third character of the pattern with the fourth character in the text. That means if you see, in case of naive string matching algorithm, the comparison is always done from left to right. That is from left side to right. It is left to right comparison. But whereas in case of Horsepool, in Horsepool string matching, Assume that this was my text and this was my pattern. First, I align the m characters of the pattern with the first m characters of the text. Now, in case of Hurst-Kohl string matching algorithm, comparison is always done from right to left. First, I compare the last character of the pattern with a character in the text. If they are matching, I compare the last but one with this character. And then I compare. If this does not match, I shift. I shift by some length. Now, if you see comparison in case of Hurst-Kohl is from right to left. This is one of the other difference between the naive string matching algorithm and Hurst-Kohl string matching algorithm. As I told, the other difference I can state that in case of brute force string matching algorithm, the shift size is limited to 1. But whereas in case of Hurst-Kohl string matching algorithm, the shift size minimum is 1, but maximum it might be the length of the pattern. In the best case, I can shift my pattern by the length of the pattern itself. So, these are the major two difference between the naive string matching algorithm and the Hurst-Kohl string matching algorithm. Now, we will see what sort of pre-processing that we are supposed to do in case of Hurst-Kohl string matching algorithm. Before going to see how this pre-processing is represented in case of Hurst-Kohl string matching algorithm, let's consider few cases wherein I'll take some sort of text. I'll consider four different cases. Case 1, let me assume that T is my text of some characters. Assume that the size of this characters, we have seen that in case of text, I have assumed that there are n characters. That is, the index of this first element is 0 and the index of last element is n minus 1. Now, assume that there is a character in the text which has a value k, and this is my pattern. Assume that this is my pattern. Don't worry whether the pattern is being shifted or not. Somewhere in some particular iteration, this is the position of the pattern and this is the content of my text. Now, what we are supposed to do, as I told earlier, that we are supposed to compare the characters from the last. So, I compare this k with r. I compare k with r. Whether k and r matches, there is no match. There is no match here. Now, whether this k is there in the remaining m minus 1 characters, I have assumed that text length is, what is the length of the text? Text size is n characters and pattern size is m characters. Now, after comparing this r with k, there is a mismatch. Whether in the remaining m minus 1 character of my pattern, is there any occurrence of k? There are no occurrence. Then what I can do is I can directly shift my pattern by its entire size. In the sense, in the next iteration, because as there are no k's in the remaining m minus 1 character, my pattern. So this was case 1. Please note that after aligning the m characters of the pattern with m characters of the text, and comparing the last characters of the pattern with a character in the text, if the compared character in the text, if it is not there in the remaining m minus 1 character, I can shift the pattern by the length of the pattern. This is the maximum shift that we can do. We'll take the second case. One more case. Assume that there are some n characters in my pattern. Sorry, there are some n characters in my text. And my pattern, once again, I'll take this example. Pattern is barber of size 6. Now, this last character of the pattern is now compared with a character in the text. Let me assume that this character is B. Now, whether this V and R matches. No, this does not match. This does not match. Now, what should be the shift size? Shift size. Now, check whether this B is there in the remaining M minus 1 characters. Whether it is there in the remaining M minus 1 character. Yes, I have B twice. I have B twice. Now, how many times this pattern should be shifted? This pattern should be shifted by the rightmost occurrence of B. The rightmost occurrence of B in the remaining M minus 1 character is at size 2. Is at size 2. 1, 2. So, this pattern should be shifted. This pattern should be shifted twice. In the sense, after shifting, this should be the shift of my pattern in the next iteration. In the next iteration. So, this was case 1. This was case 2. Let me come up with one more case. Case 3. Let me assume that this is my text. Once again, my text size is m characters. And let me take one more. My pattern as leader. Leader. Now, this R is compared with one of the character in the text. I will assume that this character is also R. This character is also R. Now, whether this R and this R matches. If you see, this R and this R matches. Now, there is one more character here. There is one more character. Don't worry about what is that particular character. The character may be anything. I may have this something as E only. Whether this E matches with E, there is a match. There is a match. Now, assume that there is one more character here by name K. Denoted with K. There is a mismatch here. There is a mismatch here. Now, what should be the shift size? What should be the shift size of the pattern? Now, note that you are not supposed to take the shift size of K. Anyway, K is not there. What we do in case of Erskine string matching algorithm is, after assume that few characters are matching, and this last character, this character in the text which was matched earlier is not there in the remaining, is not there in the remaining M minus 1 characters. If so, if it is not there, then I know that there is no meaning in comparing any of these M minus 1 characters with this R. Directly I can shift the pattern by the shift, by the size of the pattern. Now, why I have taken this example as leader? Because if I have taken it as barber, R compared with R, okay, E compared with E, but this R is there in the remaining M minus 1 character. So, third case, the last character that we are comparing here in the text is not there in the remaining M minus 1 character. After few comparison, wherein few characters are matched, but this last character, that is R, is not there in the remaining M minus 1 character. Then the shift size should be as similar to case 1, which is nothing but the size of the pattern. Now let me take one more example. One more, okay, this fourth case. In fourth case, let me assume that this is my text of M characters. And this is the position of my pattern. I'll take the same pattern barber. I'll assume that some of the characters in my text are ER. Here. Same thing, something similar to this, wherein R and R is matching, E and E is matching, but B does not match with a character P. Or maybe let me call it as X. There is a mismatch here. Now, what should be the shift size? The last character that was matching, that is R, whether this R is there in the remaining M minus 1 characters? Yes. If it is there in the remaining M minus 1 character, then the shift size should be the rightmost occurrence of this R. Where is the rightmost occurrence? Here it is there. So, I should take this R here. This should be R, B, E, R. B, E. Now this is something similar to the second case. Here in second case, the first character itself was not matching, but this B is there in the remaining M minus 1 character. Then the shift size depends upon the occurrence of this B in the right side, the first right occurrence, the first occurrence length is 1, 2, it should be shifted twice. Same thing here also, but there are few characters matching. Even though there are few characters matching, the third character is a mismatch. Even though if there is a mismatch in the third character, the shift size for this particular pattern in the next iteration depends upon the rightmost occurrence of the last character R. Last character R, rightmost occurrence is at length 1, 2 length, so it should be shifted thrice. So these are the four different cases. With this four different cases, we can be able to state that but what should be the size of the shift in case of the Hurst-Spool string matching algorithm. And this shift size is denoted with the help of a table by name shift table. So shift table is calculated in Hurst-Spool for all the characters based on pattern. This is the pre-processing that we are going to do in case of Hurst-Spool string matching algorithm. Before searching the pattern in the text, for the given pattern, we build the shift table. Shift table is not just built for only the characters of the pattern. It has been generated. It needs to be created for all the ASCII characters or all, I can say, for all the printable characters. And depending upon the shift size for each of the character, when I compare the pattern, when I start searching the pattern in the text, the shift size depends upon the shift value of that particular character. Hope it's clear. We'll see how to build the shift table with some example, and then we'll try with one or two example of finding the pattern in the text, and then we'll go for the algorithm of the Hurst-Spool. As you are aware that before searching the pattern in the text, in case of Hurst-Spool string matching algorithm, we are supposed to construct the shift table. Now, how this shift table is created for the pattern? Now, this is how we create the shift value for any character C. We have seen in the previous earlier that we have discussed four different cases. Those four different cases should be able to tell how exactly the shift value for a character can be created. Now, in order to understand this, let me take the pattern. Let me take the pattern as Barber. Now, what we do? First, the shift value or the shift table needs to be constructed for all the printable characters. If you take all the ASCII characters into consideration, then it will be 258 ASCII character. If you just take only the printable character, then we know that we have 128 printable character. Now what we will do, we will limit our explanation of this Hurst-Spool string matching algorithm only with respect to some characters, alphabetical characters. So I need to consider all the alphabetical character A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, blah, blah, O, X, something like this. Now, initially, for all these characters, I need to assign the length of the pattern. What is the length of the pattern? Length of the pattern is 6. So, before assigning 6, what we will do? First, we will take this barber. So, the position of E is at first position. 1, 2, R is 3, A is 4, and B is already repeated. B is already repeated. So, B, if it has already been repeated, I should take the rightmost C. Rightmost C value is 2, hence it is 2. So, apart from this, A, how much it is? 4. For B, it is 2. For R, it is 3. For B, anyway, it is 2. E, it should be 1. R is also already 3. Now, apart from this, for all other character, the shift value will be the length of the character. Length of the pattern, sorry. x, y also 6. So this is the shift table for the pattern barber. That means a shift table will contain an integer number for all the printable characters. If the character is not there in the pattern, then the shift size will be the length of the pattern that is mentioned here. That means if C is not among n minus 1 characters of the pattern, then the pattern length is m. If not, the length will be the distance from the rightmost C among the n minus 1 characters of the pattern to its last character otherwise. So if not, okay, the rightmost occurrence in its remaining m minus 1 characters of the pattern to its last character. Let me take one more example. Let me take a pattern as leader. Quite simple. I'll start with the first one. This is the first 2. Whether A is repeated? No. Whether E is repeated already? Yes. What is the value of E? It is 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4. This is at 5th position. Now this was actually 4. This 4 has to be overwritten with the previous value. That is 1. Now if you construct the shift table for all the printable character for A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, R, X, Y, Z. A is there? Yes. A, what is this value of A? A is 3. B is there? No, B is not there in the pattern. If the character is not there in the pattern, then its shift size should be the size of the pattern. What is the size of the pattern? It is 6. So it is 6. Now C is there? No, 6. D is there? Yes, 2. E is there? Yes. Value is 1. F is there? No. 6. G is there? No. 6. H is there? No. 6. I is there? No. J? No J. No K. L is there? Yes. Shift value is 5. M is there? No. 6. R is there? Yes. R is there. But R is not being repeated in the remaining n minus 1 characters. So remaining m minus 1 character. If you saw, that was the first case that we discussed earlier. It should be shifted by the length of the pattern. So this value is once again 6. X is there, no X. X value 6, Y value 6, and even the Z value is 6. This is how we construct the shift table. Once the shift table is being constructed, it will be easy for us to check whether the pattern is there in the text or not. To understand how Herskoll string matching algorithm works, let us consider an example wherein, in this example, I have taken the input text as Jim saw me in a barber shop. Note that in between two words, I am using this underscore between two words. Let me assume that my pattern is barber. My pattern is barber. Now what we initially do, for this given pattern, we build the shift table. Now what this shift table has, it has the shift value for each of the character. Now let me start with E. E shift value is 1, B shift value is 2, R shift value is 3, A shift value is 4, and B shift value, B is already being considered earlier, so drop this. Now these are the characters. Now what are the other characters which are not there in pattern? For all other characters, what is the shift value? Shift value here will be the length of your pattern, that is 6. Hope this is quite clear how to create the shift table. Once the shift table is being created, first align the m characters of your pattern with the m characters of your text. There are 6 characters in the pattern. I have aligned with, this is aligned with the first 6 characters of the text. Now compare R with A. Whether this is a match? This is not a match. This two character does not match. Now by how many times it should be shifted? It depends upon the shift value of A. Now what is the shift value of A? Shift value of A is 4. It should be shifted 4 times. 1 time, 2 time, 3, 4. You should shift here. This is B, A, R, B, E, R. Now compare the last character. Whether R matches with E, no, there is a mismatch. Now you should take the shift value. You should take the shift value of this last character. Please note that in case of Erskine string matching algorithm, whether it is a match or whether it does not match, the shift size will always be the shift value of the last character. Now what is the shift value of E? Shift value of E is 1. It implies that I can shift this pattern by only once. So VAR, VER. Now compare this R with underscore. Underscore. Now what is this underscore? Underscore is also an printable character. Whether it is there in your pattern? No, it is not there in your pattern. If any character is not there in your pattern, then what should be the shift size? Shift size should be 6. Now you can shift your pattern by 6 times. VAR, VER. So VAR, VER. Now compare this B with R. Whether it matches? This does not match. Now what we are supposed to do, we need to shift by the shift value of B. What is the shift value of B? Shift value of B is 2. We can shift by twice. This is first time. So this is B one time, the second. B-A-R, B-E-R. Now compare the last character. Last character R and R is matching. A and E I am comparing, but this does not match. One most common mistake that most of them do is that they will shift by the shift value of A. You are not supposed to shift by the shift value of A. You are always supposed to shift by the shift value of the last character. Last character. Now what is the last character? Last character was R. Now what is the shift value of R? Shift value of R is 3. You need to shift the pattern by 3 times. 1, 2 is third time. B, A, R, B, E, R. Now compare last and last character. R and R matches. E and E match. B and B match. R and R match. E and A match. And R and R matches. So this is how Hirschsprung string matching works. Now before going to algorithm, we'll take one more example and then we'll go for the algorithm of Hirschsprung string matching. Yeah, this is the second example wherein I have considered the text as fail means first attempt in learn. Let me take my pattern as earn. So what is the first step? So first step was a shift table for all the characters. What all are there? For R, it is 1, A, it is 2, and E, it is 3. And N, whether N is repeated? No, N is 4. And for all the other remaining things, other characters, how much it is for other characters? It depends upon the length of the pattern. Pattern length is 4, so it is 4. Now what we do, we compare, we align the first 4 characters of the pattern with the first 4 characters of the text. I compare the last character. Whether this matches? No, there is a mismatch here. Now what is the shift value of L? L shift value is 4. Shift it 4 times. E-A-R-N. Now compare N with A, whether this match? It does not match. Now shift by the shift value of A. Shift value of A is 2. 1, 2. E, A, R, N. Now compare this N and S. Whether this match, there is a mismatch. What is the shift value of S? Shift S value is 4. So shift it 4 times. E, A, R, N. Now compare R and N. Whether this matches, there is a mismatch. What is the shift value of R? Shift value of R is 1. Shift it 1 times. Now compare R and S. Whether this match? There is a mismatch. Now shift it by the shift value of S. S is not there in pattern, hence shift value is 4. E, A, R, N. E, A, R, N. Now compare this T with N. Whether it matches? No, there is a mismatch. Now shift by the shift value of T. Shift value of T is 4 once again. Hence it is E, A, R, N. E-A-R-N. Now compare this P with N. It does not match. Shift value of P, 4. E-A-R-N. E-A-R-N. Now compare this N with N. It matches. Compare this I with R. This does not match. Now what should be the shift? Shift size should be the shift value of N. Shift value of N is 4. It should be shifted 4 times. E-A-R-N. E-A-R-N. Now compare this A with N, this does not match. Shift by the shift value of A. Shift value of A is 2, 1, 2. So it is EARN. Now compare, R is compared with R, it matches. Sorry, N is compared with N, it match. R is compared with R, it matches. A is compared with A, it match. E is compared with E, it is match. This is how Hurst-Pohl string matching algorithm works. Now we'll go for the algorithm of Hurst-Pohl string matching. First, as you see, that in case of Hurst-Pohl string matching, we build the shift table. First, we'll see the algorithm for constructing the shift table, and then we'll go for the algorithm of Hurst-Pohl. This is the algorithm for constructing the shift table. If you see, the algorithm is being named as a shift table, to which the input is the pattern, a pattern denoted with P. So, the description says that this particular algorithm fills the shift table used in case of Hurst-Pohl string matching. Even the same shift table is also used in the Boyce-Moore algorithm also. The input is the pattern P, is the pattern P of M characters. Now, what is the output? Output is the shift table. Is the table. So shift table is denoted with the array table index from 0 to size minus 1. Now, as I told earlier, this value of size might be 250, that is 2 power 8, or it can even be 128. If you just consider only the printable characters, you can just take the size of the array to be 128. But note that the array indexed should be the alphabetical characters. So it says that table 0 to size minus 1 indexed by alphabets character and filled with the shift size. So what is the first thing that I am doing is, for all the locations of this table, I am initializing M. M is nothing but the shift value of, M is nothing but the size of the pattern. Now what I do, for only those character which is there in the pattern, I am changing the shift size, shift value. So I am taking a for loop for J running from 0 to M minus 2. If I run it from 0 to M minus 1, even the last character will also be considered. So if you see, what we have done is, for this barber, we have started with last but one character. Hence, this J is running from 0 to M minus 2. This was 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is M minus 1. So M minus 2 means this 4, hence it is 0 to M minus 2. What are we supposed to do? Just calculate this value. Table of P of J. P of J means for this value. Initially it will be 1, 2, 3, 5 and 4. First it will be 4 and then later on it gets updated to 2. Because the rightmost occurrence position is 2. And so on. I need to find the shift value for all the characters, and finally I return this table. And this table will be used as an input in the Hurst-Pohl string matching algorithm. This is what the this is how we are doing some pre-processing for the input. One of the input to the Hurst-Pohl string matching is a pattern. We are pre-processing this pattern to build the shift table. With this shift table, we saw that how we search the pattern in the text. Now let's go for the algorithm of Hurst-Pohl. This is the algorithm for the Hurst-Pohl string matching. The algorithm is being named as Hurst-Pohl. And if you see, the input to this Hurst-Pohl algorithm is a pattern P of size M character and a text T of size N characters. Now, the description says that this implements Hurst-Pohl algorithm for string matching. Now, what is the output? Output is the index of the element, the index of the index in or the position in the text where we find the pattern. If it is there, if it is not there, we are going to return minus 1. Hence, the output says that output is the index of the left end of the first matching substring, or it returns minus 1 if there are no matches. So what is the first thing that we do in case of Hurst-Pohl? First is construct the shift table. Note that shift table is constructed for the pattern P. So P is the input for this shift table. Now once we construct the shift table, what we do? First find the position of I. So I is the, see, for example, this is my text and this is my pattern. First I align the M characters of the pattern with the first M characters of the text. Okay, if this was the text, I will be this. I will be this. Because I is M minus 1. Why M minus 1? The array is being indexed from 0 to M minus 1. So when I less than or equal to N minus 1, the maximum number of iteration that we can do is N minus 1. While I less than or equal to N minus 1, so K, initialize K is equal to 0. This K basically gives the number of matched characters. Number of matched characters. what we do, we just compare. While k is less than or equal to m minus 1 and p of m minus 1 minus k is equal to t of I minus k. This character is compared with this. If they are matched, then we increment the value of k. So this while loop gets iterated until k is equal to m. If k is equal to m, then we return I minus m plus 1. So in case if there are 6 characters in my pattern and only 2 characters match, that is the value of k is equal to 2, what we need to do? We need to shift this. If the third character is mismatched, you saw that we need to shift this particular pattern. Now shift depends upon the shift value of this last character. So else I is equal to I plus table. Table means this was my shift table of t of i. I need to shift it and I need to check the characters once again. If it is found, well and good. If it is there, then it implies that my k value will be m. If it is not there, then finally I am going to return minus 1, which implies that the pattern is not there in the text. So if you see this particular algorithm, so how many number of iterations are there? Number of iteration is n minus 1 iteration. This I value can be less than or equal to n minus 1. That means starting from I is equal to m minus 1. So the maximum number of iteration will be n minus m plus 1. And in each iteration, if you do m number of comparison, then the time complexity of spool string matching algorithm will also be order of nm, as similar to naive string matching algorithm. But with those two examples that we discussed earlier, you saw that the number of iteration will never be n minus m plus 1. Because if the shift value was just 1, then I would have got the number of iteration as n minus m plus 1. And in each iteration, I used to compare m number of characters in worst case. But if you saw there, it was not at all n minus m plus 1, and never ever we came across a situation wherein we had m number of comparison in each iteration. So on an average, I can say that the Huskoll time complexity, in worst case, I can call it as theta of nm. In the average case, it will be linear in time. In order to understand how it is linear in time, we need to consider the different possibilities. We'll not worry about all those things. Anyway, you can just compare this with the example that we have considered earlier. If you see, the maximum number of comparison will never exceed more than the number of elements or the number of characters in the text. Hope this is clear. This was about Huskoll string matching algorithm. Thank you.